We know that the researcher needs some tools for data collection. Now, there is a variety of tools available to the researcher, and he or she selects according to the objectives, according to the theoretical framework. Every tool has its own characteristic, but there are certain characteristics which are common for all the tools. Today we will discuss those. Which are these characteristics which are common for all the tools which the researcher can use for data collection? If we can list those, they can be reliability, validity, accuracy, objectivity, credibility, generalizability, practicality, and such other characteristics. We will see some of them in details and some of them cursorily. The first one, as you are aware, is reliability. You know this word. Something has to be reliable. Reliable means on whom or on which we can depend on. Reliability refers to the repeatability of findings. If you get the findings today, the tool should give you the same findings after a gap of time. This is called reliability. It has four characteristics, or we can say that there are four types of reliability of a tool: equivalency reliability, stability reliability, internal reliability, and inter-rater or inter-observer reliability. Let us see each one of them in detail. Equivalency. When we are saying the tool is reliable, any tool will have certain questions or certain items or certain statements, and they test or they collect information on a concept selected by the researcher. Now, if we see the co-occurrence on two questions, two similar questions, or two questions which are getting information, similar information from the respondents, there should be compatibility, there should be co-occurrence. This is called equivalency reliability. This is the extent to which two items measure identical concepts at an identical level of difficulty. The test-retest reliability or inter-observer reliability we will see in a short while. But let us see what are the sources of this unsystematic threats to the reliability. One is subject reliability. Factors due to research subject. This subject reliability is established because of the subjects you have selected for. It is established because of the subjects you are selecting for the study. Now, examples could be if they are fatigued. If you are giving them the tool in the late evening, when they are fatigued, when they are tired. So, their answers to your tool may be different. This is called the threat because of the subjects. Their mindset also affects the responses on the tool. The other is observer reliability. Abilities of the observer, abilities of the interviewer, abilities of the rater are in question here. If they are not properly trained, then the responses which they elicit, the way they rate or the way they make observations will get affected. Third is situational reliability. These are the conditions under which the tool is given and the observations are made. The conditions may refer to the sitting arrangement or under whose guidance or observations this is observed or this is administered. The place where you are conducting this, these are called situational variables. They do affect the reliability of the instrument. But important thing is, if you word it wrongly, then naturally the tool is getting affected. The reliability gets affected. This is called instrument reliability. The language which we use, the words which we use, the phrases which we use, the arrangement or alignment in the statements, all this counts. The researcher's approach to creating or developing the instrument is also very important. Lastly, another important threat to the reliability is data processing reliability. Once you collect the data, how you are going to process that, how you are going to score it, how you are going to tabulate it, and what kind of techniques you will be using for treatment. If you choose a wrong technique or wrong process, then naturally the data which is handled, people can say it is handled wrongly and the findings will be wrong. It has nothing to do with the tool, but the data handling at the end of it, that makes the reliability of your tool at a threat. We know that our tool must be reliable. Now, how to establish the reliability of a tool? As a researcher, you are interested that the tool which you have developed, a questionnaire or a scale or interview schedule or observation schedule, any tool which you have developed, this needs to be reliable. Now, this reliability has to be established. Generally, the researcher is interested in establishing the high reliability. Now, how to know that whether the tool is reliable? Then we use coefficient of correlation in two observations. Let us see how this reliability is established. There are four methods. One is test-retest reliability. Other is equivalent forms reliability method. Third is split half method. And you can also use Kuder-Richardson method through formula. The test-retest method of establishing reliability is very well explained in its title, test-retest. So you take a tool, you select a sample which resembles the actual sample when you will be using for actual study. Now this sample is selected and you are giving the tool, they have answered. You have the score. Now the same sample is again invited after say 15 days or 1 month or the time which you think appropriate and give it to them once again. Now you expect that the result should be same. When we are saying the result should be same, they will not be same, but they will be near to same. Now if you establish a coefficient of correlation between these two, it should be very high level, 0.9 and above. If it is 0.9 and above, then that means your tool is reliable. People are not interpreting it differently at different times. This is called test-retest reliability. If you get your coefficient of correlation less than 0.9, less than 0.8, that means people are giving different answers at different times. And why it must be happening? Maybe they are interpreting it differently. Maybe they are comprehending differently. Their attitude cannot change in 8 days or 10 days or 15 days. So it is not a change of attitude. It is maybe the comprehension is not correct. Maybe your arrangement of statements is not correct. Maybe your tool, handling the tool is not correct. You have to find out why this tool is not showing similar results after a gap of time. Then you come back and you make modifications, change and try it again. So test-retest reliability will give you an idea about the reliability quotient of your tool. Other method of establishing reliability is equivalent form method. When you prepare a tool, you prepare equivalent form. That means similar types of questions, not exactly same questions, but similar type of questions, similar type of statements. One is putting in A form, other is put it in B form. Now these are called equivalent forms. You give these two to the same group. When they are answering, you find out the total score and find out the coefficient of correlation. Naturally, this should be high because your forms are equivalent. If it is high, that means your tool is reliable. If it is not so, then you have to come back and modify it wherever the modifications are required. We generally do this even in achievement test. When we prepare achievement test, for pre-test and post-test, we prepare equivalent forms. They cannot be exactly alike because then the test wiseness will come because we have given the same tool again. But if we want to avoid that test wiseness, then we prepare equivalent form. This is, a researcher also would require a training to prepare equivalent forms. This is one of the effective method of establishing reliability of a tool. The third method is split half method. As the name suggests, it is split into half. The whole tool has say 40 questions. You divide that into two. We have said that the tool is reliable because it is addressing the concept, it is addressing your objectives, it is addressing the theoretical framework. So all your variables are taken care of. So when you split it into half and give it to the two groups, they should be giving you similar results. If your coefficient of correlation is high, then your tool is reliable. Kuder-Richardson method is a statistical method. You use a formula and establish that your tool is reliable. When the tool is used for rating, when the tool is used for observation, then it may not be used by only one observer or only one rater. The researcher may employ many people. If they are not in agreement with each other, your findings will get affected. Why they cannot be in agreement with each other? This is the problem of inter-rater or inter-observer reliability. We have to establish that. The similar situation is observed by two observers and you find out the correlation between their observations. If this coefficient is high enough, then your tool is reliable. It is, we are establishing inter-observer reliability or inter-rater reliability. Suppose you want to evaluate certain websites or certain educational portals. Different raters will be using your tool. So, if they are not in consistence with each other, they are not in agreement with each other, the findings may be affected. So, one thing is that you can train them how to use it, what is the meaning of each statement, understand the language, understand the continuum which is used. This kind of a training will bring them on the same platform. So, they know exactly what is to be done. This would help to establish the inter-observer reliability. We are talking about two observers, but this may happen that the same observer may rate differently at two different occasions. How to solve this problem? Of course, here also the training is required, and if a lot of fluctuations are there, then you may have to replace that observer, because that observer himself or herself not really up to the mark for being an observer for your study. While establishing the inter-observer or inter-rater reliability, if there are categories, then you can find out the percentage of agreement between two observers. If it is a continuum, then we can take the total score and find out the coefficient of correlation.